I participated in my first ever DNF Duel Tournament without having played a single game. Let's see how it went. That said, so I spent a significant time in training mode and did all of Vanguard's trials. So you see, I've got the German text in there, so it's Aufklärer. And the opponent, which is who uses a DLC character, Spectre, is called Schattenklinge. So tell me in the comments which names you find cooler, the English ones or the German ones. I'm pretty sure that Vanguard is cooler than Aufklärer, but yeah. That aside, my opponent does not seem to have played that much DNF either. So the problem with DNF is it was kinda a game that was dead on arrival. So apparently in the beginning it had some glaring balancing issues. And while most people said it was fun and found it fun, there was not enough not enough pull for most players to stick with the game, and so it more or less died out over the years. And focusing a bit more on the match here right now, you see my opponent Jin Amamiya, as he called himself, definitely has some more experience than I have. 11 matches played online, and I don't know, of course you never know how much they spent in training mode or whatnot and how fast they learn. But yeah, all in all, the first round was fairly convincing from him. And what I've been noticing over the course of the match, not only this one but in entirety, is that most players I faced in the tournament really like to use all of the meter. So this game has some very unique meter system, as it generates on its own, but at the cost of that every special essentially costs meter. And you can use special motion inputs to let the recovery start earlier, but the costs are the same. And yeah, the Spectre is zoning me out fairly well here, and also has good tools apparently to close the gap, but the sweep gets me in this first match. And in the second match, let's see if I can adapt in any way. So yeah, at that point I'm still too shaky with the combos, because I could have gotten something good enough at the very least here. I don't want any optimals, of course, because I'm not the kind of person to do research before playing. I just pick up the game and see what the game teaches me, and then when I decide to go full on Sweat Lord, then of course I look up all the optimals, or not all the optimals, a few optimals, learn them, and then go implement one thing at a time, which I find is a lot better than trying to fit in everything at once. That said, I might get the round here. Yes, a simple special into special cancels cures me the round here. But of course, only one round, I need to win two rounds. And also, this is first to three, as you can see the title, so a little bit different than usual. And I can't really see the reason, because yeah, the matches are still fairly long. So maybe this is because I'm a defensive player and I don't really know enough of the game, because I believe the damage can be quite volatile in this game, and as you see, every normal has crazy range, which is also why apparently my character Vanguard struggles a bit, because he's supposed to be the long range specialist, but as you see, Spectre has no problem contesting the range. So yeah, definitely not makes it easy. And for this reason, tell me in the comments if you want to see the same character again, if I ever enter a DNF Duel tournament, or if you want to see me switch the character. I'd be open to both possibilities, and in a similar way, just tell me which kind of games do you want to see on this channel, because this is definitely one thing that I'm curious about. I know the algorithm really is pushing for Granblue, that much I can say. But of course, I don't want to only play Granblue here. And yeah, back special is the one where he swings his stuff around, which is really cool. And yeah, this round looks good for me. Okay. Really difficult for me to commentate this because I really don't know much about the game. And I kinda said anything aside from the game. Ooh, that was close. If they hit me, then I would have been dead, but that wasn't the case. So yeah, I take my first game in this set. And of course, that already puts me a little bit at ease. So now my, I don't know, few hours Vanguard didn't do nothing. He took a game. And that's already worth something. But of course, as I said, DNF Duel, not the most active game. Ooh, I got a combo here. Yeah, I got get almost a full combo, I believe. I could extend here even further, but that was definitely some good stuff for me at that point. Very convincing round. Almost looks as if I were knowing what I would be doing. So yeah, maybe if I played this game a little bit more. But again, this the problem with DNF Duel, it's pretty much dead, so I had to console to Discord to find matches, and I'm not necessarily the one to do so. So that's a bit sad, because otherwise I'm very much a fan of playing those smaller titles and hanging out with the smaller communities, just because they are more intimate when you talk to each other. Like in those big communities, no one knows no one, except for of course the top guys. But in the smaller communities, everyone knows everyone. And also that usually means that when you play a set with anyone, then then you immediately get some feedback what you can improve upon, and that can be very helpful and very nice. Of course, it always depends if you want to hear some feedback right now. And as I said, it's actually getting close, but yeah, my opponent definitely good at keeping me out. And me not being good at offense and pressure in general definitely hurts here. Even though I wouldn't know how to approach this. Like, the best thing I can think about in this matchup, from what little I know about the game, is that my best bet is probably to snipe them out when they try to get to me. Because, yeah. My mobility isn't great, my damage is probably pretty good, but of course I don't really utilize it that much. Okay, nice back special. And yeah, I didn't notice Sets, but you can, I mean, I touched it a little bit, but you can actually do any special without doing a special motion input and just using a command and a button. Ah, so close. Okay, so it's one hit for either of us. And yeah, they don't drop, so they take the second game from me, but at the very least I got one, and again it's a 1-3, so another match here. And again, I don't really know the reasoning, like the matches are not very so it's organized by the Hollow Knight, so this is the Hollow Knight side event 6. With DNF Duel this time, it's organized by Kemo, and he's mostly a idle Showdown player as I know, but he also enjoys himself some DNF Duel. And so, especially because I feel like in comparison to idle Showdown, these matches are a lot less long. I mean, are pretty much the same length, because both games are pretty explosive. And so I don't really know why this is 1-3 and Idle Showdown was 1-2. But that aside, I'm winning. Maybe? Nah, okay, this was a good dodge. So similar to Granblue, this game has dodges. A forward dodge and a backwards dodge, but it doesn't have this neutral dodge that Granblue has. And I actually win a round here. I'm a lot stronger than I remember, to be honest. Kinda amazing. I felt terrible after the tournament. I was like, I'm so bad and I didn't want to see anything or play anything. So what I did after the tournament is play lots of Dragon Quest Monsters. Good game, by the way. Okay, nice dodge from myself. Okay, this doesn't connect from my opponent. Okay, this was a nice bait, so they went backwards to catch my attempt at punishing their attempt, if that makes any sense to you. And yeah, the one problem that I had, so I was talking to Orange Cuts about the character Vanguard, because he also played him, and he was like, yeah, this character should be something for you, because he's a lot like Kagura in a way, that he has big range normals and he could punish accordingly. But what I've been probably not good enough to know, but I really don't understand how he's going to open his opponent up. As in with Kagura, I usually have a high-low throw option at any given point, but with Vanguard I have pretty much neither. It's only mids, apparently. I would have thought that the one hit where he hits from above with his lance, that would be an overhead, but it wasn't. And this round is all them. But again, they played until they didn't have any special moves left. And apparently the zoom stuff I notice now is not a special move, which is interesting. Okay, and then we trade here, so, but yeah, couldn't make the comeback possible. It's definitely something that you will see a lot more here with my next game against NekuCrow or NekuCrow. And so you may probably don't know him that well, and sadly I couldn't give you any info about the Jin guy, but I know for NekuCrow that he's a plus R and an idle showdown player. We've actually played some friendlies in Idle Showdown. He's a lot better Bikura than I am. But in this game, of course, we don't share the character. And I actually get a combo going, but don't get the off the ground OTG hit from Vanguard there. I think it's a little bit weird. Essentially, I have to jump up and hit with my spare downwards to shake the ground, and then I can get the pickup. Again, a little bit weird. And one thing that I noticed in this matchup against Geisterklinge, or Ghostblade in English, is that I can essentially hit the ghosts the same way I can hit Karls or Aurelius puppets, so Nirvana or Ada. So here I did this exactly. But he did very well to avoid my avoid my attack with his dodge. And yeah, I'm just trying to somehow stay ground, so he tried to dodge, but of course when I... This is very daring right now. Okay, and I still get a hit. And I get another hit with the pixel nest. Kinda exciting here. This was also a requested match by... but Kemo, who I mentioned earlier, was very interested in how this plays out. So if you're watching this, very much appreciated, Kemo, and yeah, I will always record my runs so that the world can see what happened, and I can take a look every time and see where I can improve. Which is probably one of the biggest upsides for me as well, because I do know that not that many people are watching my videos to the end, which is also why I put the questions in the front this time. And ooh, I get two combos in a row. Yeah, not far and not close enough to get the second hit of the air special. Wow. Nice throw here. Ah, and that could have been it, but at the very least I get the other L hit in there. And my first game win. So I go off 1-0. It's really good, and again, this was another hit I should have gotten. after this bounce, Sadie can't get a combo as far as I know. Maybe I'm wrong and there's something that is very specific. It was essentially more or less a misinput from my side. And you definitely see the difference in playstyles here from NekuCrow and myself. So yeah, like, yeah, I'm all defense and sometimes I get a good hit in and then I try to capitalize from it as much as possible. And of course, if you're not fairly new to the game and don't know what to punish and stuff, then that's pretty difficult. He has a little bit more of an offensive playstyle, but of course he's still trying to bait a lot of stuff, which is really good. So essentially we see some very strong adaptation from him here. Another counter hit, and apparently he can combo off those. Doesn't get the full combo, I believe, so I'm still in it, but I don't get the full combo either, so that's the problem. I believe with if I had gotten extended the combo, I could have taken the round and continue my momentum, but now the momentum has swayed in NekuCrow's favor. And again, yeah, I'm probably fairly safe after those, but still, I go back to neutral with pretty much no reward and no way to mix my opponent up, apparently. So yeah, definitely, should definitely try out some more characters. As in right now, I don't feel him and I don't feel the game as much, too. So like with Idle Showdown, I immediately saw the appeal of the game and was kinda hooked. But with DNF Duel, might be a slow startup, that happens at times. Like back in the day when Persona 4 Arena came out, I threw that round. Okay, but I still got it. KO. But back in the day with Persona 4 Arena, I remember not liking the game very much, feeling like it was a super dumbed down game for babies, and it was. And yeah, it was just worse BlazBlue. But I continued playing it and was played in an amateur tourney, so not anything like I do today. But yeah, I got second place there, and that actually motivated me to play a lot more of that game, and I really enjoyed it afterwards. So honestly, it might be similar to with DNF Duel right now. It's in a weird spot for me personally, as in and NekuCrow gets this round, but it's in a weird space right now, as in it's not complex enough that I'm like, whoa, this is the game, but it's not simple enough to be like, okay, I can pick this up and just have fun. So that was the case for Idle Showdown, essentially. And with this game, I spent quite a lot of time, as I already told you, in training mode and in tutorials. I still really don't know much of the systems or how to use them. Like, I know the concepts, but I can't use them in combat. But on the same time, I don't see the depths that I have in a BlazBlue when I pick up a new character, where it feels like a complete new world is opening. But yeah, again, I should give it more time and see. But of course, there are other games also fighting for my time. Yeah, I'm fighting for my time. I'm definitely not like, I drop this combo and now I get destroyed here. No, okay, he dropped the combo as well, I believe. Okay, this was a nice dodge from me, but somehow he was able to hit me out earlier than I was. Probably because I pressed the too long startup button. It isn't all that great. Okay, he gets a knockdown, but he didn't convert. Okay, corner setup in this case. I believe he could have gotten a combo, but cut it short intentionally to get the reset. Another grab. Yeah, he's going for the grabs because he understands I don't really tech those. I don't really have that in me in this game at the very least. And yeah, he gets the second game on the board. I need to improve my game if I want to continue in the tournament. But yeah, again, pretty difficult as on how to approach this. Like from afar, he could essentially zone me out with his ghost. Not much that I can do, and then he can run up and oppress me with his faster buttons, I believe. And if I want to run up like this, then his pokes have long enough range. So really, wouldn't really know what to do when playing Vanguard. But of course, just playing more and more games would definitely clear up some of those questions, I believe. But right now, I would be a little bit dumbfounded on how to approach this matchup, how to improve it next time. Like, you see what he's doing, so yeah. He's completely commanding the pace and I'm just reacting. And whenever I get a hit, I fumble too much, I don't get a combo out of it, and thus not a favorable position. And on the other hand, he gets himself good positions afterwards, and he combo drop again. Probably my nerves getting the better out of me. As we've seen in the earlier matches, I've done a lot better in terms of combo execution. Yeah, I'm too far away for that. And one thing that I also find interesting and confusing a bit, that I can't chain my low L's into my regular L's. And speaking of L's, that's what I've been taking. So NekuCrow advances in the tournament and I'm out. So that was the Hollow Knight side event 6. You can enter the next one for DNF Duel or for Idle Showdown if you want to. And thank you very much for watching. See you then. Bye bye.